fabulous segue into my next question, so maybe I might throw that back to you then, Paul, which is what prompted then your last career change?
So, yes, I was managing my business, and we had an independent chairman, and the two of us fell out, and it was a fairly toxic environment, so I was asked to leave. So it was a company that I spent 15 years founding, building, working with a great group of people. We'd achieved a lot, and then suddenly I was sort of out of my ear. So I really struggled and needed to work out again what I was passionate about, where I wanted to be, and in fact needed to get a better mindset because I was really negative. And it took me a few months to get over that. And I happened across a mindset called mental toughness, which is really around being resilient and confidence and approaching life as an opportunity rather than looking at what it is, which became attuned to. So I set up a business really to develop that and teach that. So that's one of my, I've got three, I'm a portfolio professional now, so I've got three careers, that's one of them. And so myself and the coaches, we would help people develop a mental toughness mindset.
Great.
And we can measure that with a psychometric tool that we have from there. So it wasn't my own doing, I was out of my ear, having to be employable rather than employed.
Fantastic. So you just made that decision to pursue that career based on something you learned that was interesting and supported you, and you saw some value in it?
Absolutely. So yeah. Yes, I wasn't clear about that. So I was just completely lost, and having this framework was a great help to me. And therefore, I was able to... I feel that my... when I was younger, I was very shy, so I learned listening and then developing empathy by accident. And so that's developed into my career. So I've helped people with their career management. And I found that mental toughness was a cornerstone of coaching and assisting people in their career and their life.
Great. So that drawing on that strength to take it into a different platform, a different vehicle. Great.
Absolutely.
So maybe I'll open those two questions up to Megan and Cassie as well about what prompted that last career change, and then how did you choose where to go, or how did you decide, or what happened there? How did you get on that path?
So for me, I was mainly working in the arts, and the last sort of key role during my first child was at ArtsACT. So I moved to Canberra for a little while, and I first was at the Canberra Theatre Centre and then back in ArtsACT, more my area of arts policy and funding. And there I would do a lot of analysis on the businesses that were going up for their annual or triennial funding. And there I would notice and think, you know, these businesses, they really need an improvement, but I didn't know how or what to, how to improve them. So a bit further down the track, I had my second child, and I went, you know, I've always wanted to know if my other brain side, you know, the other side of my brain will work. So I started doing a Masters of Commerce, starting to think about how organisations are structured, how do you actually improve organisations. And from there, you know, I tried to do like capital finance. I had a lot of tears over that, and realised that part of my brain, the mathematical side, just wasn't going to function the way that the other side works, and more about humans and people. And so I became more interested in the org development side, and really, you know, that realisation that really people make an organisation. So from there, I got into my org development. I was starting to do this master's, and then my relationship, 14 years, three children, we separated. So I went from, you know, being probably the corporate housewife, where at least, you know, my partner at the time could pretty much support the fact that then I could do all these wonderful arts and little non-profit organisations when we could still live in Sydney, to suddenly having to pay the rent in Sydney. And that's probably what kind of gave me that extra, you know, jump, because it was necessity more than anything. Mm-hmm. I just needed to suddenly change my career. I decided change management was where I found great interest, and that's really where I went from there.
Fantastic. It's really interesting to hear how it was something you were interested in exploring with no probably sense of outcome. It was really curiosity that's led you into the masters, and then there was sort of a bit of a side channel. I like how you talk about divergent. You went into the corporate finance area and it's like, this just isn't working. I'll go back to what, again, is where my slightly comfort zone, but also where my real interest lies. So you clarified that, and then that brought you forward into looking for perhaps organisations that had more resources to provide you with the income you needed. Mm. Yeah. Mm. But I love that little side journey you talk and how that helped to affirm that you were on the right path, yeah.
And the interesting thing, I've been doing quite a bit of, reflection, especially having a few questions help reflect. And I've been looking a lot about creativity and bringing creativity in the corporate world, because it's something that everyone's talking about at the moment. And I think a big part of being a creative individual is that you do, just by the methods that you learn in art school, because I actually started as a visual arts student, you do explore quite broadly, and then you start to sort of hone down into something, and then you kind of explore. So, yeah, if you think of it that way, yes, it's kind of something that I've grown to do as well.
I came across a phase, again talking to vet teachers, about embedded creativity, that idea of taking those skills into other sectors, and how you teach that as well. And I think it's really exciting you're starting to explore that, having experienced many elements of that and seeing the transferability. Fantastic. So Megan, what about you? How did you, prompted you, and how did you get on your path?
So there's a couple of external things that prompted me. For me, I see it as kind of two different changes. So just after Judith and I were working together, I took a voluntary redundancy. I was pregnant at the time, so I took a year off. And so the external factors were, what now? I'm a mum. What might fit into my lifestyle of having a child? So at that point in time, I retrained as a drama teacher. So I went back, did a Bachelor of Teaching. And then I was working for somebody else. But for me, that's probably not the significant bit. It was then, just after my second daughter was born, and she was going into school, where I was working didn't fit anymore. And at that point in time, it was, okay, what can I do that I can still remain a mum, that brings in money, that works as well too? Not, if I'm going to give up time with my kids, it better be damn important as well. And I was lucky enough that I did have the luxury of actually being able to think about it, because my husband was full-time employed, okay, where he was. So I did have a bit of leeway to go, okay, what can I try? So that's when I thought, hey, I think I realised I'm now completely unemployable, because I can't be told what to do anymore. So I was a trained high school teacher, so it was a choice between going into a high school or teaching what I actually wanted to teach and not what somebody was telling me to teach, and that's what I chose to do. So it was certainly scary. I had no idea what I was doing, definitely. But it just, again, I had a bit of space to be able to give it a shot, I guess, which helped, definitely.